Welcome back to my channel, and though for those of you who are new, my name is Tanji B, creator of Tanji Beauty. Moving on, I'm really, really excited about today because we are going to basically be trying on DIY makeup, and I don't have any makeup on because we're gonna make it ourselves. We are going to be using Make It Up. It's a book I got recently about a year back from Marie Raimea. I'm really excited about trying out this particular DIY experiment because we are going to test out eyeshadows. And eyeshadows are my first love in makeup. We're gonna take the recipe that is created in the book and we're going to compare it with the other eyeshadows I typically have, like the more commercial ones, particularly the Anastasia Beverly Hills palette, and see how they compare to each other in terms of texture, how they feel, how they last, and overall how I like the formulation itself. Okay, so it's time to put on some safety gear and we'll get started. So to start the formula off, we start with 2 teaspoons of Sarasite Mica, which helps with diffusing the light properties in the eyeshadow, as well as giving oil control. And then comes in the cornstarch because your girl didn't have any arrowroot starch, so we did 2 teaspoons of that. Next, we added 3/8 teaspoon of boron nitride to the mix, and it's a great ingredient for adding adhesion to a formula as well as more oil control. Face it, nobody wants crusty looking eyeshadow or eyeshadow that disappears at the end of the day. Now we're adding 1/8 teaspoon of magnesium stearate and 1/8 teaspoon of magnesium mistrate, both which help a product feel more buttery and adds that nice slip to an eyeshadow. And then we have calcium carbonate in the mix. We add 532 teaspoons, this amount. Yeah, so you basically need that much for your calcium carbonate. And fun fact, if you guys have eggshells in the fridge, you can actually grind it up into a powder form and make your own calcium carbonate. But this version that I am using, it is a vegan version, so no eggs in this formula. Yay! So all of our dry ingredients are all ready to go. We're gonna actually place them all into a coffee grinder and have it grind up into a really fine powder. I got this coffee grinder from Amazon and I actually really like the way it works. It's very quiet and the blades are really nice at pretty much combining all the powders together. Per the book, the coffee grinder is a great tool because at the end of the day, like, these are powders and it's really hard to mix them just by hand and making sure you get a uniform product. So the coffee grinder does all the work for you. In the book, there's this tip to wrap your coffee grinder with some saran wrap and then putting the cap on top to ensure that the dust particles or powders don't fly everywhere. And I love this tip. This is like awesome. It definitely helped in decreasing the amount of cleanup I had to do. There wasn't any large amounts of particles or a large amount of dust that I had to deal with at the end. Now we're going to give this a good mix for 20 seconds or so and ensuring all the powders are again uniform. Make sure you let the dust settle. I didn't really follow directions in the book when it came to this, and you could see that after I took it off you could see some powder flying a little bit everywhere. So this is where I knew I messed up, because there's this part in the book that says to add a couple drops of jojoba oil and vitamin E oil, and I added way too much jojoba oil on accident because I didn't have a pipette and it's heavy and it was chunky and it was gross. And so I started all over. I didn't understand why it was so heavy until I realized it was probably because of the cornstarch and I shouldn't have substituted. So I had arrowroot starch the next day. And then we did the formula all over again with all the other pieces staying the same, boron nitrate, yada yada yada. We put it in the coffee grinder, gave it a good whir for about 20 seconds. Again, and then now we finally got some nice fluffy eyeshadow base. Arrowroot starch definitely made it more light and airy, and it is literally beautiful. Using 2 teaspoons of the base, we added 132 teaspoons of yellow iron oxide and brown iron oxide with a bit of gold mica. There was a part in the recipe that required titanium dioxide, which I didn't have, so I added more gold mica to get this because the gold mica ingredients had titanium dioxide in it, and then I packaged it up into this little guy here. We'll see if it actually impacts how it pulls through on my eyes, but right now it looks really, really nice inside. Like, I love the color. You can definitely see the gold specks coming through from the mica. Okay, so we're back and I'm really, really excited to try this out. It is actually really beautiful. I could definitely see like the brown pigments going, like, coming through on this shadow, and it is so shimmery, and but it's not like overly sparkly. So we're gonna try this out on the eye and then see how it swatches. So it's on but you can't see it. Okay, so like I think it's my fault that this happened this way, because I actually did not put any titanium dioxide, but instead doubled up on the mica. And even though like it turned out really nice, like I think I needed the titanium dioxide because the whole responsibility that titanium dioxide provides in a formula for eyeshadows especially is to increase opacity. I really didn't want to bring titanium dioxide into the house or like experiment it on my first roundabout because if I accidentally inhale it without knowing, like that would be detrimental to my health. So I can't speak for longevity, unfortunately. I know we said we were going to talk about longevity of the product, but instead we will definitely talk about the texture of the product. So texture wise, I actually found this to be really soft. I was really surprised at how smooth it was on my fingers. If you guys have the Anastasia Beverly Hills palette, I would recommend just like touching one of the matte colors that they have. And it's actually very, very similar to that. When it comes to spreadability, I really actually liked how this product spread. I thought it was gonna be really, really messy, but it actually covered really well, even though the color didn't pull through on my eyelids. I'm also not having any other reactions from it. Like even if I had some fallout on my cheeks or something, like I was totally fine. Like I haven't had that feeling in such a long time. I haven't had this feeling since I tried out Urban Decay's first naked palette, and with that palette I didn't have any allergic reactions, like no ocular pressure. Like I feel like nowadays the formulas are definitely changing, and not to say that they're bad, but I'm definitely noticing more reactions on myself when it comes to eyeshadow formulas. So overall, I really enjoy it actually making this recipe. I feel like it's a really great DIY eyeshadow. We're definitely going to experiment with this more, so I feel like I'm going to make a part two of this. If you guys like this video, please like, comment, and subscribe. I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye!